Anchored to the seafloor, tiny sponges made of glass stand tall amid the violent currents and crushing weight of the ocean. The secret to the Venus flower basket's astounding sturdiness lies in the complex structure within their tubular glass skeletons. Over billions of years, evolution hones the architecture of not only the large-scale structures within organisms, but also the microscopic building blocks of those structures themselves. This enables organisms to use a minimal amount of material to achieve maximum performance. Humans, meanwhile, use about 100 billion tons of material per year to make everything in our built environment. This produces about 25% of global greenhouse gas emissions, and a third of this material ends up as waste. By examining structured materials in nature, can we find ways to take our own engineering to new heights of performance and efficiency? Let's take a closer look at the Venus flower basket's skeleton. It's a tube made of glass, but it's built up from vertical, horizontal, and diagonal struts. The skeleton's open cellular architecture allows it to compress, bend, and stretch in ways that solid glass never could. The same is true of bone and wood. Humans, too, have made tremendous strides by learning to replace solid mass with open cellular structures. The Eiffel Tower, whose network of trusses was modeled on the internal structure of a bone, is twice as tall as the Great Pyramid of Giza, but it weighs 1,000 times less. Now, engineers at a company called Metavoxel Technologies have designed simple building elements about the size of a credit card that can be mass-produced and assembled by high-speed robotics into 3D cellular building blocks. When connected together, they form metamaterials that exhibit properties the raw materials themselves do not possess. Different initial shapes impart different properties on the metamaterial. Simple open squares give strength and structure. Add an accordion bend on each side, and that slight amount of give is multiplied many times over to create a squishy material made out of much more rigid matter. With this revolutionary approach, novel metamaterials could be designed to have unique, customizable properties determined by other cellular geometries. And they can be produced from a range of materials, including wood and biocomposites, to make strong but ultra-lightweight construction materials for buildings, bridges, furniture, and vehicles. And so much more. Metamaterials also need fewer raw materials, so they can sharply reduce the amount of resources being extracted from the earth, shrinking our carbon footprint and helping humans live in better harmony with our planet, learning from nature's way of doing more with less.